Welcome back. Just I am teaching you the literature, and just the topic is the magic bonbons. And up to now, I have gone through 6 pages of the topic, and just today I am going to teach you the page number 12. 6 pages of the topic, and just I am going to teach you now the page number 12, and just up to 11 pages or up to 5 pages I have completed. And before going through the page number 12, just I am going to tell you the previous one or the summary of the previous whatever I have taught. And just before, we have learnt about the Bessie, when the Bessie Bostwick brought the bonbons in her house, and when all the people took the bonbon, the professor, her parents, and she herself took the bonbon, and the senator kept the bonbon in his pocket. And when the 4 people took the bonbon in the house, and they created different kinds of work, they started doing different kinds of works simultaneously, and because of that we laughed, and it creates the humorous situation there. And simply when we went through in the previous video, simply you laughed more there. And just from the 12, I'm going to start what happened after that. Yeah, Mrs. Bostwick managed to get them all seated, although her husband had broken into another area, and then the maid brought in the soap. And just when all the persons like the Bessie Bostwick was playing the piano in the air with her hand, and the professor was hitting the thing whatever was being brought over the ear, and just her husband was singing a song, and she was herself started the speech, although she managed to sit all the persons on their seat, and her husband went to other area. When she carried a plate of the professor, she cried in an excited voice. And when the maid brought up in the soup, and when she carried a plate, yeah, brought the other plate, and the air professor saw that, and he excited, and he cried in excitement, because of the bonbon, he had the capacity to hit anything above 6 feet high. So by looking it, he became very happy. "Hold it higher, higher," I say, and springing up, he gave the plate a sudden kick and sent it nearly to the ceiling. And he kicked it, the soup and the plate went to the ceiling, from whence the dish descended to a scattered soap over Bessie and the maid, and to a smash in pieces upon the crown of the professor's bald head. And just when he hit, just it smashed or descended to a scatter. No? Descended to a scatter, and just being a scattering, it fell on different parts, on the Bessie Bostwick body and the maid body, and also on the crown. It became the crown of the professor's, because he was bald-headed, and just it fell on the head of the professor. At this atrocious act, the senator rose from his seat with an exclamation of horror and glanced at his hostess. And as we know, the senator was the person who hadn't taken the bonbon. He had just kept the bonbon in his pocket. Because of that, he was very sad by looking that, and he was feeling just a fear because of the action. He was horrified because of their action, because all the people who were pretended there are doing different kinds of activities, but he hadn't taken anything, so he was calm, so he was unable to digest whatever was being there. For some time, Mrs. Bostwick had been staring straight ahead with a dazed expression, But now, catching the senator's eye, she bowed gracefully and began reciting the charge of the light brigade in forceful terms. And when the senator was surprised and he was horrified, or he was feeling very fear, and that time Mrs. Bostwick stared him or looked him, and after looking, just she bowed gracefully, like she was going to start any topic to present, or she was going to start to deliver the speech. And before delivering any speech or presenting any speech, anybody simply bow like that. And by bowing, doing her head down, she started reciting or started presenting the speech on the charge of the light bridge in forceful tone, in a loud tone, she started presenting herself on the topic. The senator uttered such disgraceful writing he had never seen or heard before in decent private family, and the senator trembled. He was surprised along with fearful too, because he hadn't expected in a private family or in a simple family, when anybody calls guests and just present themselves, like doing different kinds of activities which simply can hurt the guest. He hadn't expected that it could be happen there, but it happened. He felt that his reputation was at stake, and being the only sane person apparently in the room, there was no one to whom he might appeal. And just he was very sensible, and just as I told you, he was a reputed person, and he was very famous there. Because of that also, he was thinking that his reputation was ruined, because no one was respecting him. All the persons were presenting themselves in their own way, without thinking that the senator had seated there. And there was no one to whom he can blame, just appeal or tell the thing. There was no one, because whoever were there presenting their activities. The maid had run away to cry hysterically in the kitchen. Mr. Bostwick was singing "Oh, Promise Me." The professor was trying to kick the gloves off the chandelier. Mrs. Bostwick had switched her recitation to "The Boy Stood on the Burning Deck," and Bessie had stolen into the parlor and was pounding out the overtune from the Flying Dutchman.
Wow.
And here, the maid, being feared, feeling feared, she, like a mad, started crying, and she went to the kitchen, and the Bostwick, Mr. Bostwick, started singing other song, "Oh, Promise Me," a lovely song, and the professor was trying to kick his gloves off the candelier, and Mrs. Bostwick had started presenting her speech on other topic, "The Boy Stood on the Burning Deck," and the Bessie, who was being stopped there because of her mother, went to the parlor room again and started playing the piano on the Flying Dutchman. Yeah. The senator was not at all sure he would not go crazy himself, so he slipped away from the turmoil and taking his hat and coat, horrified from the house. And just senator was, as I told you, senator hadn't taken the bonbon. Because of that, there was no effect on him, so he was unable to tolerate whatever being happened there. He was going crazy, so he went from there and just left the house. That night he sat up late writing a political speech he was to deliver the next afternoon at Faneuil Hall, but his experiences at the Bostwick's had unnerved him that he couldn't scarcely collect his thoughts. And just at night, when the senator went to house, he wanted to write a political speech, but he was unable to write, which he had to deliver the speech there. but he was unable to collect his memory and just unable to write on the topic because he was nervous because of the activities whatever happened there in Bostwick house, and he was confused, and he was so surprised that anybody who simply calls someone at the house to treat or to just present his hospitality, but here he didn't get anything. Here just all the Bostwick family disrespect him, no one care about him, and he was a reputed person. Because of that, he was unable to digest it, and now when he was at his house and he was writing the speech to deliver, just he was unable to write or collect the ideas or thought to write there because of his that condition, a present condition. Often he would pause and shake his head pityingly as he remembered the strange thing he had seen in that usually respectable home. And just he pityingly, being unhappy, he was shaking his head to remind the thought, but the thought which he wanted to present was unable to come in his mind, and just he was reminding the thing whatever happened at the Bostwick family house, so he was unable to write nicely. The next day he met Mr. Bostwick in the street, but passed him by the stony glare. He felt he really could not afford to know this gentleman in the future. And the next morning, when he met the Bostwick at the time of going to deliver his speech, but passed him by with a stony glare, just staring him, he went without just bidding or greeting anything, or just without telling anything, he passed them, and he failed not to meet them in the future. Mr. Bostwick was naturally upset, yet in his mind there lingered a faint memory of some quite unusual occurrences at his dinner party the evening before, and just really he was upset because of his activities. He was upset, and just the thing that was happened there, that was in his memory, and that was occurring it in his mind of whatever happened at the dinner party before evening, the previous evening. So he was so surprised, and he was so confused, upset, and he didn't know whether to resent the senator's behavior or not, and just he was unable to adjust away, and he did not know whether to resent the senator's behavior or not, and just he was not thinking that the Mr. Bostwick, because of the Mr. Bostwick behavior, and just at that time he was confused, senator was confused along with him, yet together with the Bostwick was also confused because of his behavior. He hadn't expected that will be happen there, because he hadn't thought that kinds of activities could be at his house, but he didn't know the reason why it happened, because when he invited the guest, he was fine, but at the time at evening, all the persons at a house started doing different kinds of activities, so he was also upset because of his behavior towards the senator, and at last he was thinking that the behavior of senator will be changed or not, or like the senator behaved him without speaking or without greeting him, he went to present the speech, his political speech in the hall. He was thinking the behavior would be changed or not. The political meeting was the feature of the day, for the senator's eloquence was well known in Boston, and the senator was the best speaker, one of the best speaker of the Boston, and it was known there. And so the big hall was crowded with people, and in one of the front rows sat the Bostwick family with a learned Yale professor beside them. And just all the people know about Senator's speech. He was the fantastic person who presented a great speech there. Because of that, all the hall was crowded, all the hall was filled up, and the people were gathered there. In one of the front rows sat the Bostwick family, and the Bostwick family was sitting at the first row, in front of him, and El Professor was also beside them. Then all looked tired and pale, and the senator was rendered so nervous by seeing them that he refused to look in their direction a second time. And just he was confused looking all those persons who were sitting in front of him. He didn't want to look them in front of him, although they were sitting there. So he was so confused to deliver or present his speech. Just today video, that much, just I have 13, and just only 2 pages are remaining. Again, I want to tell you the same thing. Be safe and try to save your family.